This is not another story. This is not another drill. I refuse to be another number now. Never staying down. This is something real. I'm a name that you'll remember. I am more than just a thrill. I am gonna be the greatest ever now. Watch out, I'm a force that you will feel. And it goes something like, ooh, I'm victorious. Ooh, it's my time.
Hi guys, thank you for joining us today. We'll be briefing you about Delta Force, what the club is all about, and why you should apply for the Delta inductions this year. If you have any questions along the way, do feel free to post them in the comments, and we'll be sure to answer them in the end. So, let's start with the very first question. What is Delta Force about? Well, many could tell you that Delta is a technical club that handles the softer requirements during fests. You might have seen the cool websites, the mobile apps and games that we have built during Festember, Pragyan, Netfest and so on. You might also have seen the NITT's official website that is also handled by Delta. But that's not all. We are a group of people with various skill sets who are all passionate about programming. We join some of the biggest hackathons like the Smart India Hackathon and the Flipkart Hack Day and work on interesting projects and have won prizes. We regularly participate in competitive coding contests like the ACM ICPC, which is one of the biggest international competitive coding contests out there. We have a lot of fun in CTFs, which is Capture the Flag. For those of you who don't know, CTF basically consists of different hacking challenges that require you to exploit vulnerabilities in systems. We also work on contributing to open source organizations in programs like GSOC, the Google Summer of Code. Now, apart from participating in such global events, we also conduct events of our own. One of our greatest traditions that we follow is weekly scrums, where all members of the club meet up regularly to just catch up on stuff. We talk about the projects that we have worked on, new concepts that we have learned, new ideas that we have come across, new problems that we have faced, and how we have approached it. Trust me when I say that these meetings can be really insightful. And it sometimes leads to lightning talks or hacker talks, where we discuss about a completely new topic. And sometimes it leads to a brand new initiative, like the DWOC or the Delta Winter of Code. Now, apart from this, we also work on some personal projects. You can see some of the cool projects that we worked on, like the RL Chess AI, the Anime DL, Generative Art, Messy Analysis, and so on. Some of the projects here, like the CPCLI, Plagiarism Checker, the CSER Twitter bot, are projects under the Delta Winter of Code, a program which encourages all student developers from diverse backgrounds to contribute to technical projects of their choice, and thus promoting the open source culture within our community. Now, another question that comes to our mind is, are there any perks of working in Delta? Well, back in campus, we have a 24-hour access to Sun Labs, which is one of the few places to get a high-speed internet connection. Apart from that, we are provided with a server of our own with a 64GB RAM that we can remotely access from our homes and use for our projects. Another huge perk is the close-knit network of passionate people working with you. You will enjoy the benefits of an excellent peer group and the strong support of our alumni. These are some of the companies where our alumni are working in and the universities that some are studying in. I bet you can recognize a couple of them. Now, time to get into the specifics of the inductions. You can apply for the inductions through three profiles: web development, app development, and system administration. Let's see what they are.
Hello peeps, this is Indresh, web developer at Delta Force. And yeah, I'm here to brief you about web dev profile. We are full stack developers who does vivid front end and the untold back end. We are the ones who are responsible for maintaining Institute website and keeping it up to date. We develop websites and game for Pragyan or Festember or Netfest or Awake, or our own events like Delta Winter of Code, also for some activities in college like Scholarship Portal, Rembook, etc. Be the induction website or the vibrant mystery site, everywhere we have our hands on. I guess now you got to know what all we do. We play around with different stacks, we mess around with a lot of programming languages, we style with CSS, we draw on canvas, we call the APIs, we post the requests, and we are the ones who write those random stuffs in the console. This list will go on. After joining Delta, we worked on different projects in different stacks. That's when I realized I learned the skill of learning and adapting to different languages and stacks. We here in Delta collaborate, put in all our ideas, put in all our creativity, and make those cool looking website. Don't get scared that this guy is using a lot of jargon. Last year, when I was like you watching the induction briefing, all I knew was some basic HTML tag. I believe that the websites are built using HTML and some programming language. But within the induction process period, I learned a lot of stuff. I can even say I was enlightened by the knowledge of web development that I was able to write scripts and websites to automate my tasks and help out the lazy me. I started developing websites from scratch. I developed few games from scratch and got addicted to those games which I myself developed. So, by the end of this induction process, we guarantee you that you will be equipped to build websites of your own. Yes. Let's hope we meet you guys in the induction process. See you soon, guys. Bye.
Hello everyone. This is Satyamurthy from CSE second year. I am an Android developer at Delta. As you all know, we are millennials, which is why phones are such an important part of our lives. Even though our parents tell us to come out of this virtual world, we still love being in it. From texting, liking photos, to calling your friends from playing online games, everything happens through applications, also known as apps. Due to this pandemic, our only option to connect with the world is through these apps. In Delta, we create such apps that are available on the Google Play Store. We build apps for various fests like Festember, Awake, Knitfest, Pragyan, and also Pragyan events like Dala Street, etc. When developing these apps, a lot of thought goes into it. We follow an architecture pattern like MVVM, MVP, write our own ProGuard rules, use dependency injection, take care of caching, and finally publish them on the Play Store. For inductions, we are currently focusing on Android native development. But in the club, we build app for a variety of platforms, including iOS. I understand that this may appear daunting or sounds like overwhelming, but trust me, it's not. If you start from the ground and work your way up slowly and step by step, you will find that it's not difficult at all, but rather it's enjoyable and more exciting. When I was at your position last year, I didn't know much about Android development, but through the induction process, I learned so many new things. My mentors were very helpful. Overall, it was the best learning experience. The whole induction process is designed for learning rather than inducting. Finally, I can guarantee you that you will be able to create a nice and useful apps in the end. When you see your friends using the apps which you created, it is the happiest moment of your life. If you don't know which profile to choose, then don't worry. You can apply for all profiles. Try out new things, play with various platforms, and in the end, choose the profile which you love the most. Alright then, see you at the induction process. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.
Hi guys, I'm Anirudh. I'm a second year CAC student. So I'm here to talk about the system administration profile. So SysAd is an interdisciplinary profile. We mainly work with servers to make sure that all the sites made in Delta work seamlessly. We deploy websites and apps made in Delta. We perform various server maintenance tasks such as backing up of server data, writing configuration files for softwares like Apache, etc. But we do not limit ourselves just to that. What's impressive is that we do all of this with terminal commands and scripts without access to any graphical user interface. So this might sound scary at first, but it's pretty cool once you get the hang of it. Now let's talk about the most interesting part of being a SysAd in Delta. We regularly participate in ethical hacking competitions like Capture the Flag, popularly known as CTF. So in CTF, we usually find exploits in vulnerable servers or binary files to get a secret message hidden in them. So trust me, it's a great experience when you hack your way to get the flag. So during the CTFs, you learn a lot about scripting in various programming languages like Python and Bash. And also you learn about databases, networking and security vulnerabilities. So all this might sound overwhelming and difficult to start with. To be honest, when I applied for this profile last year, I didn't know anything about system administration or terminal or any scripting languages. But the induction process is designed in such a way that you can easily learn all this. By the end of the inductions, you will know how to write scripts in various programming languages to automate your work and making and deploying your own websites. You'll also learn about various networking concepts. So we will provide you with all the materials you will need to learn this. So the fun part of being a sysad in Delta is like you'll often run into unexplored domains and new problems. So it's really interesting to solve them. So if you love working with backend and find hacking interesting, do apply for this profile. So see you guys at the inductions.
Now you've heard about our profiles, but you still may or may not be familiar about the work that we do. We understand. To help you get a better idea, here are some of the projects that we've worked on.
Hello everyone. I am Priyanshu Dangi, a sophomore and a member of Delta Force NIT Trichy. I've worked on various projects under Delta, but this one's something special. Yes, we haven't seen college since March last year, and most of you guys, the first years, have never seen it. And I know, we all are missing it. But as we can't go to college, I thought, why not bring college to a home? And that's why I built this virtual tour. Let's jump in. The project is mainly of two parts, the 3D model and the web. I've used Blender for the 3D model and 3JS library for the web. 3JS is a JavaScript library which helps us in rendering 3D models over the web with the help of WebGL. The project has pointer lock control which helps us in rotating around, and it also has user control for moving with the help of these arrow keys. If you guys don't know, this is the college main entrance, and the building you can see in front is the admin block. We actually worked on something similar in one of our internal Delta hack, and that's where I got this idea from. Didn't know any of 3JS or Blender before starting this project, but I learned while doing it, and that's what we do here in Delta: learn and build. That's pretty much it about this project. I hope to see you guys during the inductions. Take care and stay safe. Goodbye.
Hey everyone, I'm going to show you a demo of Beer Factory, one of the games developed by Delta Force, which is hosted every year at Pragyan. Beer Factory is an online multiplayer game testing the art of strategy and resource management. We aspire to push our limits every year to bring new and exciting features to players, and this year was no different with a bunch of new features. But first, I'll give you a quick introduction about the gameplay in case some of you aren't familiar with it. Your role is to manage a factory which can produce beer or wine, and your objective is to fulfill demands placed by retailers. So as you can see, your factory can produce beer if you place an order, and your factory can store your stock which you produce. All the retailers demand a certain quantity of beer within a certain deadline, and you need to transport beer from your factory to these retailers within that deadline. Now for example, I can transport say 80 beers from my factory to the retailer 3 whiskey tiers. And this cost is going to be deducted from my money. And that is it, my vehicle is on its way. Now as I was saying, there is also a popularity rating which you get based on how you fulfill these demands. If you're going to delay and supply beyond the deadline, your beers are going to be wasted and your popularity is going to fall. Your popularity is what determines the future demands from these retailers. Now, for example, if you're low on money, as a last resort, you can always go to the bank to take a loan from. The bank may or may not give you the loan based on your credit score and your ability to repay the loan. Now, the backend of this game is handled by a Django server, which is based on Python, and the frontend uses React for the UI and 3.js for rendering the 3D maps. Moving on, the game has three modes. We have the normal mode, the duels mode, and daily challenges. In the normal mode, you compete against an opponent, which is actually an AI-powered bot, which is also going to try to fulfill all the retailer demands. It is based on a state-of-the-art reinforcement learning algorithm developed by Google's DeepMind called the Asynchronous Actor-Critic Agent Algorithm or A3C algorithm. Reinforcement learning is a type of machine learning where an agent learns to interact with its environment by trial and error and feedback or rewards based on its actions and experiences. This bot has been trained by playing thousands of games against itself and is indeed a tough competitor. In daily challenges, you would be provided with a specific set of resources to complete a task based on which you would be rewarded. And finally, there is the dual mode, which is actually a new feature implemented this year. In this mode, you could play in real time against other players in a competitive time-bound game. Based on your performance, your rating would be updated, and these ratings are calculated based on the ELO system. The other new features this year are better maps and power-ups. This year, we improved the graphics performance on the front end by making our maps with Minecraft models, which resulted in reduced texture sizes. We had four different theme-based maps this year, which added to the immersiveness of the game. And finally, we have power-ups. These can be purchased to give you a temporary boost on your factory and vehicles. The factory power-ups give your factory a production boost, and the vehicle power-ups improve the capacity and speed of your vehicles. We had hundreds of players this year who participated enthusiastically in Beer Factory. And yeah, that is it, guys. All the best and hope to see you during the inductions.
Hello everyone, this is Mahesh.
And this is Roshan. We are a part of Delta and we are going to show you a demo of Pragyan Premier League. PPL is a cricket management event where people can buy players to form their own teams to compete with other players. The objective of this game is to win as many matches as possible and to climb on top of the leaderboard.
Here, for front-end, we use React and Material UI, and for back-end, we use Golang as number of matches happen concurrently. Now, let us see how PPL works. The first step is to buy a squad of minimum 11 players with given initial budget. Users can buy or sell players at later stages also. After that, we can select playing 11 and choose batting order, bowling order, toss preferences, and fielding setup for different phases of match. After selecting the desired setup, we click on the submit button to confirm our changes.
Now let us look in the dressing room. Here we can see the players in our squad. When we click on a player, we can see their confidence, form, and stamina. These three factors affect their performance in a match. When a player wins a match, their confidence and form will increase, and if they lose a match, it will decrease. If a player plays in a match, their stamina will decrease, and if a player is rested for a match, their stamina will increase. We can also increase a player's stamina by using energy boosters, which can be bought in the shop here. And we can see the list of purchased boosters in the inventory here. Now, in the dashboard, we can see upcoming matches, recent matches, and any friendly match requests received from other players. Now, let us look at a match being simulated. We can see the scores of a match here in the scorecard. You can see the scores being updated in real time. You can also see the commentary in real time being displayed here. And finally, you can see the match details here. And moving on.
In squad performance, after a match has been completed, here we can see the performance of our players in both league and friendly matches. We can devise new strategies and playing 11 combinations based on these stats. And in leaderboard, here players are ordered by the number of league matches they won. And if users have equal number of wins, they are ordered by their net run rate.
Now, finally, let us look at the daily challenges. So this event goes for 8 days, and in each day there will be one daily challenge, and the difficulty of the daily challenge will increase as the day goes on. So to play a daily challenge, we click on this play button and we choose a team. In this case, I'm choosing the default team that might be by me before. And the result of the daily challenge will be displayed here. And if I win the daily challenge, I get rewarded with the energy booster.
Hello guys, this is Sailesh from the dev team of the current edition of Dalal Street. Dalal Street is a virtual stock trading game which was a part of Pregnant 21. The game happens over a period of 7 days and the participants buy, sell or mortgage stocks in the market during the game. The objective of the game is to amass the most wealth, which is the sum of the total cash that you have plus the total worth of the stocks that you own. And the player who has the highest net worth at the end of the 7 days are declared the winner. Talking about the stats that we used, for the backend or the server side, we used Golem along with gRPC API. We used Golem because in the previous editions, we had more than 1,000 concurrent users who were buying and selling stocks at the same time. In such a scenario, matching the orders swiftly becomes a top priority to ensure a market stability and a smooth user experience. Golem offers a robust concurrency architecture which enables us to match various orders both concurrently and swiftly. Moving on to the gRPC API, it is a high-performance remote procedure call RPC framework. It uses protocol buffers for communication, which serializes the data to binary format. This helps us to reduce the network payload by a lot, thus ensuring quick communication between the server and the user. Another reason for gRPC is that since Golem and gRPC were developed by the same organization, that is Google, they complement each other and are easy to integrate. For the front end, we used React, which allows us to manage the state very easily. Besides web, we have built the Android app completely in Kotlin native. Once the user has logged in, all of the game's features is at the user's disposal. So what the user is supposed to do is to head over to the company's page to have a look at all of the in-game companies. This page gives details regarding the company, such as a brief description about the company, and also a few other details which help the user to determine the stability or the volatility of a particular stock. After having a view at all of the companies that are available, the user can head over to the exchange in order to buy stocks from the exchange. Here you can observe that GameStart company has 80 stocks that are available in the exchange. So on buying 5 stocks, so 5 stocks were bought of that of GameStart at 6,600 from the exchange. Okay, so you can also observe that one particular company's buy option has been disabled. This is because that particular company had been bankrupt that year. So this is left to the user's hands to devise the perfect strategy in investing in stocks based on the particular stock's price fluctuations that can be found in the company's page, and also keeping a track on the news that we publish every market day. So these news give an idea regarding the fluctuation of price of the particular stock. In order to be able to track a particular company's news, the user can head over to the company's page and can also find company-specific news in that page. Okay, so the trading terminal is where all the trade occurs. Here you can observe all of the buy orders and the sell orders for that particular stock. For buying or selling, the user has three options. The user can limit buy or market buy or stop loss buy, and the same thing goes for selling. So on placing an order for two market buy orders of GameStat, so what actually happens is that it gets matched to the minimum amount at that instant itself, and the buy order is complete. So this is what market buy is about. For more details regarding these, the user is supposed to head over to the help section where all of the game's details and the instructions is found. This year's new feature is the daily challenges. So a list of daily challenges is given to the user on all market days, and on completing that particular task, the user is rewarded with cash, in-game cash. There is also the leaderboard, which the user can keep track of, and also the prizes are given away based on this leaderboard. Portfolio page gives details regarding the stocks owned by the user and also the reserve stocks, and also it gives the transaction history of the user.
Now, you've seen some of our projects and you've heard quite a lot of technical terms. Maybe you find it hard to relate. Maybe you have a lot of questions. Here are some testimonials of people like you and like me describing their experiences in Delta.
Hi, this is Saloni, a second year CSE student, and I've been a part of Delta for about a year now. And as cheesy as it sounds like, Delta has been a dream come true for me. A year back when we had the briefing in our hostel, I didn't go down to attend it because I never felt like I was good enough to do anything related to tech. I'd heard about Delta and its various domains before and after I joined the college, but even though I was interested in coding, I was never the best at it. So Delta was that out of my league club for me that I never thought I could fit into. But with the motivation from a few people, I still applied for inductions, and that's where my journey began, with the help of my mentors who gave me the drive to continue what I was doing. So yes, Delta did teach me a lot about technical things and how to work with newest technologies, participate in hackathons, and a lot more. But more importantly, it taught me how to teach myself and learn by exploring and enjoying the process of learning. And something that I greatly treasure is the kind of support system built within the club. The non-existence of hierarchy and the freedom to approach anyone in the group, even an alumni, for the smallest of doubts. The kind of female support and promoting women in tech is incredible. From having one girl per batch a few years back to now having four of us, we feel like intellectual equals and engage in fruitful conversations and feel more confident than ever before. So it's a beautiful learning environment that pushes you to push beyond your limits and approach problems in a more effective manner. And one thing for most of you is that Delta is not just a monotonous continuous cycle of coding, but it's much more than that. From not fitting in to feeling like I belong here, it's been a hell of a journey for me, and I want you all to experience this too. Delta encouraged me to not limit my efforts to what I initially thought were my boundaries, and the process of induction and everything that followed helped me escape the prison of my mind. And I know it will do the same for you the moment you decide that you will give it a try. So hoping to see you all at inductions. All the best and thank you.
Hey everyone, I am Subhash from 4th year Chemical Engineering. I'll just take a few minutes to talk about how much impact Delta has had on my life. I was someone who was always very interested in computer science but didn't really have any prior experience as such when I joined this college. And of course, there's this problem of me being in a completely unrelated department, that is chemical engineering. From there to here, I've come a long way, and Delta is the only reason for the same. In my first year, I still very clearly remember one of my seniors who is currently working at Microsoft in the United States told me that if you are from a non-CS department, Delta is practically your only shot at a good CSE career. I didn't really understand the statement to its full extent at that point, but now, 3 years later, I realize how true it is. To talk about a few things that I've done in Delta in the past few years, I worked on so many cool projects and participated in a bunch of coding competitions like hackathons, ICPC, and won most of them. I also did various internships, including one at Goldman Sachs, which is considered to be one of the top companies that visit our campus. I then received a placement offer from the same company. This is just to show how much help Delta can be for a clueless first year who is stuck in a branch that he doesn't like, who has nothing but the passion and dedication for coding, which I can safely assume that a lot of you have in abundance. So make use of it, try out our induction process, don't be scared of the competition, don't be scared of that CSE guy you know who has 5 years of coding experience. You will make through our induction process if you have nothing but genuine dedication and the ability to learn quickly. The best thing this club will provide you is the wonderful peer group. Of course, you know a lot about the cool projects, cool tech and everything that we get from the club. But this is the most underrated aspect of it. Every day you sit in a room with people who are like-minded and are so talented in computer science who eventually ended up in places like Google, Microsoft and whatnot. Just being surrounded by such people will motivate you to do so much cool stuff. The role that my seniors played in shaping my career and personality is very, very significant. That experience is priceless, both in terms of the knowledge that you get and the fun that we had. Honestly, the hackathons I traveled to and the all-nighters I pulled off in the Delta room are some of my best college memories. We also have a very strong alumni network. There are Delta alumni at various top companies and universities, and I can approach them for anything at all, and they won't hesitate to help me with anything. In fact, most of us in Delta have done at least a few interns which were made possible only by the direct help of some or the other alumnus. For example, even when interning at Goldman Sachs, one guy randomly pinged me and told that he is from Delta and he passed out of the college some 10-12 years ago. That is how strong our network is, and that is how willing people are to help out juniors. I'll be joining the same alumni network very soon, and I will do anything to be of help to my juniors. This club will define your entire college life. Actually, it changed my entire life, and that's no exaggeration. Even if one of you get the same experience that I got, I'll be very happy. It's making me emotional to even think about how much this club means to me. And you might not understand what all of this means now, but you will definitely understand this once you get into the club and are on the verge of graduating. Hopefully, that motivates some of you to apply. See you at inductions. Remember, one club can change your life.
Hello everyone, a brief introduction about me. My name is Nirvik Ghosh. I'm from the 2011-2015 computer science batch. I currently work at Apple. I'm a part of the distributed storage team here in US. I've been in this company for the past 2.5 years, and I'm here to talk about my experiences in Delta. Before we get into that, I want to talk about the time when I first joined college. I used to hear a lot about this really hard to get coding club, which was only for the brightest of the brightest minds in NIT Trichy. You know, like, I would like to clarify today that none of that is true. You don't have to be the brightest of the brightest, but indeed it's one of the coolest freaking clubs I've ever been part of. With that being said, for me, when I wanted to get into this club, I learned this really cool language back then, Python 2.7. It's just not there anymore, but okay. I used that language to basically scrape images off the internet and do some basic scripting activities. And eventually anything I felt that was manual could be automated, I just automated it. And that's something that my seniors really liked. And that's pretty much how I got into the club. And what the club basically looks for is high level of motivation and curiosity, and some examples of how you can demonstrate both of these. The reason why I mentioned those is that I used to be the kind of guy who didn't know how files get downloaded over the internet, how databases work, how operating systems work, how the internet works. I didn't know any of those things. But as long as you're curious and you're driven to answer each of those questions to its very core, you're a perfect fit for this club. And once you become a part of this club, you're going to be surrounded by some amazing, amazing talented people like your seniors, your peers, your juniors. When I first joined the club, I thought that I was just going to learn about system admin stuff, but I ended up learning about networks, security, web development, front-end development, back-end and game development, even hacking. And that was bloody awesome. And the best thing about the club is that you and your team are gonna come up with ideas, and you're gonna sit and solve those for like hours and hours. You're gonna have some amazing technical discussions, and those are the most rewarding experience ever. And okay, in COVID times you can't go for hackathons, but back then, like, we used to go to like different states and like attend hackathons. We were very shameless. We used to go for like the competition and the free food. The food was amazing. But yes, go for the competition, meet great people. You're going to get some amazing swags, but make sure you do those kind of things virtually. I think it's now you have to do it all virtually, but these are some amazing experiences you're going to have. And once you get out of the club, you will never be afraid of trying out anything new. And that is very, very rewarding. With that being said, I wish you guys all the best. If you want to talk to me or like connect with me, shoot me a message on LinkedIn. Bye bye. This is not another story. This is not another drill.
On a few tasks in the profiles that you applied, followed by a project in the end. These tasks will help you learn about and gain experience in the profiles you've applied. So to help you get kickstarted with the tasks, you'd be connected to a mentor for each of the profile that you apply. That is, let's say you apply for a SysAd and web dev domain. Then you'd be assigned two mentors, one for web and one for SysAd. Now, how does this mentor help you? The mentor helps you out with doubts, gives feedback, and shares resources relevant to your profile. Hello everyone. I'm confident that the profile talks and demos would have given you a deeper insight into what our club does. Now let's take a look at how we induct people into the club. So the induction process will start around 10th of May and will last for about 2 months. During this period, you'll be working on a few tasks in the profiles that you applied, followed by a project in the end. The tasks will help you learn about and gain experience in the profiles you've applied. So to help you get kickstarted with the tasks, you'd be connected to a mentor for each profile that you apply. That is, let's say you apply for web dev and SysAd domain, then two mentors would be assigned to you, one for web and one for SysAd. So how does this mentor help you? So the mentor helps you out with doubts, gives feedback, and shares resources relevant to the profile. Simply put, if you're stuck anywhere during the process, your mentor is the way out. They'll support you and help you gain the maximum out of inductions. So the task stage will end before your end semester begins. And the rest of the induction process will resume at the beginning of your third semester. So coming to your induction projects, this can be a project from any field of computer science. But We highly encourage you to explore and show off your skills through this project. As you might have seen in our project demos, we don't restrict ourselves to three profiles mentioned before and work on all computer science domains. We believe that once, if you're good at one facet of programming, you'll be able to pick up all others easily. Hence, once you're inducted into Delta, there are no restrictions on what projects you can work on, and you aren't limited to the profile in which you were inducted. Now, moving on to what we expect from you. We do not expect you to have any prior experience in coding. All we care about is your passion for programming, your ability to learn and adapt, and your perseverance throughout the induction process. And I guess this was one of the most frequent questions which was DM'd to us in our Insta account. So your department, current skill set, CGPA, none of that matters. Your selection will happen only on the basis of your coding proficiency, interest, and dedication. So I guess the induction process is pretty clear to all of you. And if you guys have any more questions, please feel free to post your queries in the chat. We'll be answering them pretty soon. Thank you.
Oh, sorry, I was muted. Yeah, okay, so hi guys. Anand here, joined by Pavitra for the Q&A session. And I think we can get started with the most common question that you guys have been asking throughout the induction process, is that whether you can apply for multiple profiles. And the answer to that is yes, you can apply for any profile you want to, and you can apply for multiple profiles, but do make sure that you are able to complete the tasks completely in at least one profile. You can also drop any profile at any point of the induction if you feel like your interests have changed. Moving on.
I guess the second most frequent question which you guys asked us was that, are there any prerequisites to participate in inductions? So the answer would be no. There are no prerequisites. All that matters is your interest and passion. If you're new to coding, that's fine. You can start from scratch. We do not have any prerequisites. we look at how much you learn throughout the induction process and not what your skill set is at the starting of the inductions. And
So next, a lot of people have asked us if they can be a part of any other club or team and be a part of Delta as well. And to that, we don't place any hard restrictions on any teams that you can be a part of, except you won't be able to be a part of Pragyan because we already conduct a lot of Pragyan events for the fest. But apart from that, if you're able to manage your time well, you can be a part of any other team and Delta as well. If you want to get clarified on any specific club or team, feel free to DM us on Instagram and we will be able to clarify your doubt.
Yeah, the next question put forward by you guys is, when will the induction process start? So the induction process will start right after this briefing ends. We'll be releasing a form soon in which you would have to fill your profile choices. And the deadline for closing the form would be around a week, post which we'd be allocating you mentors.
Right. And this question also keeps coming up. If non-CSE people or non-circuital people can participate in inductions, and I guess we have made it very clear that we will not consider your department at all when we are inducting you. If you're good at coding, good at programming, and are able to show interest and learn how to code, we will be glad to induct you into the club. And we can, yeah, and that's it.
Okay, so the next question is, how do you choose a domain? So if you are a beginner to coding, then it's better if you're confused as to which domain to start with, then we'd recommend you to apply for all the domains and try out a couple of tasks in each of them and see which one aligns with your interest the best.
Right. Then coming to a very important question. What about things other than development? Is Delta a club which does only web app dev and sysapp? And well, you must have seen our demos and have gotten an idea of the kind of projects that we do. We take up projects from all domains in computer science itself. For example, the bot in Beer Factory was a reinforcement learning agent which was trained using ML algorithms. And we have also participated and won several blockchain hackathons in the past year and so on. And like Pavitra mentioned during the briefing, we don't place any restrictions on what kind of projects that you can take up once you have gotten into the club, right? And we will make sure that you have support in doing whatever project that you want to, apart from the quotidian regular tasks that we also do, right? And we can also, there's also one more related question about the presence of algorithms or a competitive coding stream in our inductions. We consider algos to be essential to all forms, be it some development or some research programming. It doesn't matter, right? You will need to know some basic algorithms for all of them. And for that reason, we don't place a separate algos profile, and we expect everybody to know a bit of algorithms as well. We have over the years qualified in several ICPC events and a lot of others as well. Right, moving on.
Okay, so a lot of you have asked whether we have any specific programming languages that you all should know, or is any of the programming language fine? So how our induction process is designed is that in each of the domains, you'll have a few choices when it comes to choosing your languages. For example, in web dev, you'll have a couple of languages to choose for the backend part. And we'll ensure that you'll be given resources for all of them. And the final choice is up to you guys.
Right, so moving on, we also have a lot of doubts about some non-circuital people sharing about their experience in Delta. As you saw in the testimonials, we had a testimonial from Subhash, who is from the chemical department, and I think that serves as an example of non-circuital people in our club. And yeah.
The next question put forward by you guys would be, is it fine if I have no prior knowledge on web dev but have a huge interest in web dev? Yes, it is completely fine if you are new to web dev. You can learn it during the induction, and you'll have ample amount of time to learn and do the tasks. A lot of my batchmates, seniors, and even the juniors have learned everything from scratch during the process. So you'll have no worries. You can start from scratch.
Yeah, so finally, one of the most important questions: how many students do you induct from first year? So I want to say this right now, we don't have any hard limit on how many people we induct to the club. And if you're able to show your skills and show to us that you're good at programming, we will induct you.
So I guess we are done with the Q&A session.
Are there any other queries? Just please post them in the chat. We will be around for a minute or two.
You guys have anything else? Just
And don't feel shy to ask any sort of questions, because I'm pretty sure others will have the same as well. And if you have any reluctance in asking questions, please don't be, you can always DM us on Instagram and we will be able to solve your doubts. Right, somebody has asked where to apply for inductions, and to that we will be circulating a form and a website soon. It will come up mostly tonight or tomorrow morning at the latest, and you will be able to apply over there.
Okay, I think this would be the final one. So a lot of you have asked whether Delta works in the field of AI. So as I mentioned earlier, while explaining the induction process, we work on anything and everything inside the club. We do not restrict ourselves to the three profiles that we mentioned. It's just a basic qualification for you to enter the club and for you to do a certain quotidian tasks. But other than that, you're free to work on anything when you're a part of the club. We have no restrictions on that. Do we have any more questions?
Oh, somebody has asked how many PIs will be there as part of our induction process. And so, like we mentioned, this semester, until your NSEMs, you will be having a task phase where you will complete a set of tasks and try to learn as much as possible from them. And after your third semester begins, we will be having another round of on-sites and a hackathon and so on, during which we will be having PIs as well. This stage of the induction process will be disclosed later as the dates nearby, depending on the medium and so on.
Okay, so one last one. A few of you have asked whether Delta has lateral inductions. Yeah, we do have lateral inductions, but it's considerably harder than the normal inductions. So we'd highly recommend you all to try for inductions now itself. And yeah, if this doesn't work out, then you can give it a shot at the lateral inductions. Okay, so we have one last question here. So one of you have asked, I know a little bit about C language. Is it fine for my selection? So yeah, it's fine if you know C language. You'll be learning a lot of other languages during your induction process. And what we look for during inductions is not your current skill set or what languages you already know, but the amount of concepts and technical skills that you're going to learn during the induction process. So, yeah, I think we come to an end with our inductions briefing. So, yeah. So, thank you guys for attending the briefing. We really hope you guys apply for inductions. And yeah, the forms will be put out soon. See you guys at the inductions. Bye bye.
This is not another story. This is not another dream.